happy day students, welcome to class 7 mathematics. So today we are going to study about chapter 5 exponents. So in exponents I have divided into two parts. So the first part we are going to see about exponents. Okay children, okay, let us start with the picture. So do you know about the area of square and volume of a cube? Yes, so we already studied about the square and then 3D shapes also. Yes, so the area of a square is side square. The area of the square is side square and the volume of a cube is side cube, isn't it? Yes. If the length of the one side is A, then what will be the area of the square? It will be called as? Yes, exactly. Okay. If the volume of the cube will be A, then what will be called as the area of a square, children? It can be written as A into A, which is A square, right? So what about the volume of a cube? So it can be written as A into A is equal to A cube, right? Yes. Next, so students, if you will be see carefully, there is a number which is upper right corner. There is a number which is upper right corner of A. Right, children? Yes. What is that exactly? Do you know that what is that exactly? So, we often cross this kind of numbers. But do you know what exactly it indicates? Tell me, children, do you know what exactly it indicates the right hand side corner of A? Yes. So, this number, nothing but it is exponent. This number, this is nothing but it's an exponent. We can be say exponent. Either it's an index, either it's a power. Right, children? Okay. Let us look. So, in this chapter, so we are going to study about the exponents elaborately. Okay. Let us have a look at this number. So, see the number here. So, the first number is 2. Okay. And the second number is 2 plus 2. And third number is 2 plus 2 plus 2. And the fourth one, 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. Then 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, etc. And 2 plus 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 2. Clear, children? Okay. So, in this 2, we can be written as 2 into 1. And this 2 plus 2, it can be written as 2 into 2. And this 2 plus 2 plus 2, it can be written as 2 into 3. Because the 2 is repeated 3 times. So, it can be written as 2 into 3. And here the 2 is, and 2 is repeated 4 times. So, it can be written as 2 into 4. And then here 2 is repeated 5 times. So, it can be written as 2 by 5. So on. So, here it is. The 2 is repeated 10 times. So, it can be written as 2 into 10. So, what can we say using this in this number? Yes, it can be called it as repeated addition. Okay. Now, look at the next picture. So, its first one is 2. And 2 into 2. 2 into 2 into 2. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Then, it's 10 times repeated. 2 into 2 into 2. Okay. So, how can we write if it is 2 into 2? So, we can be call it as this is repeated multiplication. As you are seeing in a previous slide, that is repeated addition. Because it is 2 plus 2, then 2 plus 2 plus 2, like that. But here, if you are seeing all the numbers, middle you are seeing, which is multiplication symbol. So, we are saying this is repeated multiplication. Let me come to the next one. Yes. So, as you are seeing, 2 is equal to 2 power 1. 2 into 2 is equal to 2 power 2. So, 2 into 2 into 2, it can be written as 2 power 3. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 power 4. So, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 2 power 5. And so on, 2 into 2 into till 2 power 10. So, is it possible to write if it is 2 is repeating for 50 times? Can you write this? It's kind of 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, etc. It's still 50 times. So, it is taking more time to solve the problem. So, how can we write in a shorter way? For that, our mathematician has found, like if it is 2 times or repeated, we can be write 2 power 2. If it is 3 times or repeated, 2 power 3. If it is 4 times or repeated, 2 power 5. If it is 5 times are repeated, 2 power 5. If it is 10 times are repeated, 2 power 10. So that our mathematician has found the shorter way to write the numbers. So it can be called it as exponents. So see, this 2 into 2 into 2, there are 3 times of 2 is equal to, how can we write in the exponents? Exactly, children, which is 2 power 3. So we can be call it as this 3 is a exponent. The 3 is a exponent, or else we can be say it's a power. Instead of exponent, we can be say that's a power. And then the 2 is a base. So whatever number is in the below of power, that will be call it as base. Whatever is in the power, that can be call it as exponent. Am I clear, children? Which is exponent, which is base? Yes, I hope you understand. So this kind of numbers, we can be say exponent, index or power. And let me show you the rational number in this exponent form. So the product of rational numbers multiplied several times by itself can be expressed in the same notation, which means the product of rational numbers. See here, 2 by 3, it's a rational number. So which is the power is 4. What about the base here, children? Tell me, what about the base here? Exactly, children, this is 2 by 3 is a base. Exactly. So the power is 4, isn't it? Okay, so the 2 by 3 will be repeated 4 times. The 2 by 3 can be repeated 4 times. So this is the shorter way to write. Now we are going to write in the longer way, which is 4 times the 2 by 3 is repeating. So we can be write 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 into 2 by 3. Am I clear how to write in a longer way? Yes, if a by b is a rational number, then a by b is equal to, it can be written as a by b into a by b. A by b into a by b is equal to, we are multiplying with the power. We are multiplying with the power a into a. So a into a, multiplying the denominator. So b into b. So how many a's? A square. How many b's? B square. So I hope you understand in this problem also. Now, using that exponent, we are going to solve some problems. Listen, children. Listen, the first problem. So 3 by 4 whole power 2. So we can be call it as this 3 by 4 is a base and this 2 is a power, or it's a exponent also, is equal to. So 3 by 4 is repeated how many times? 2 times. So this 2 is common for 3 as well as 4. So now we are taking this 2 inside the brackets. So if we are taking, the 3 can be written as 3 power 2, and the 4 can be written as 4 raised to the power of 2 is equal to. So 3 raised to the power of 2 is equal to 3 into 3. 4 raised to the power of 2 is equal to 4 into 4. So 3 3s are 9, 4 4s are 16. I hope you understand the first problem. And let me show you the next problem, second problem. Minus 2 by 3 whole to the power of 3 is equal to. So this 3 is common for minus 2 as well as 3. So we are taking inside the brackets. So minus 2 whole power 3 divided by 3 whole power 3. Okay, is equal to. So minus 2 will be repeating 3 times. So minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2 divided by 3 into 3 into 3 is equal to. So 2 2s are 4. 4 2s are 8. So 8 is the answer. But coming to the operation, minus into minus is plus. Plus into minus is minus. So the numerator answer is minus 8. Denominator 3 3s are 9. 9 3s are 27. So I hope you understand the second problem also. Now let me show you in the another formula, another example. Express each of the rational number in exponential form. So as you are seeing, this 81 by 256, it's a rational number form. So this rational number form can be written as exponential form. That is the question. Okay. So see, this 81 can be divided into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, so how many 3's will be taken for 81? Which is 4 3's. So it can be written in the exponential form as 3 power 4. Because the 3 is repeated 4 times. So we can be write 3 raised to the power of 4. So which is the base here in 3 raised to the power of 4? Exactly, 3 is a base, so 4 is the exponents. Okay, similarly, 256, it can be split up. 4 into 4 into 4 into 4 is equal to 4 to the 4 raised to the power of 4, because it's a 4 fours. So 4 raised to the power of 4. Now, which is 81 by 256. So we have to be write it. So what is 81's exponents? 3 raised to the power of 4. Right, children? Yes. And what is the exponent for? What is the exponent for 4 raised to the power of 256? 4 raised to the power.
Okay, now the power is same, the rise to the power is the same. So we can be take it as 3 by 4, a whole to the power of 4.
So I hope you clear in this question also. And thank you, children. So I hope you understood the exponents. And in the next part, we can be see the laws of exponents. In the next part, we can be see in the laws of exponents. Until then, bye-bye, children.